word from the Lord.
Preach.
And it is in the book called Hebrews.
Yes, sir.
Hebrews chapter number 2. If y'all give me 30 minutes, I believe we'll hear what the Spirit says to the church.
Preach, sir.
Verse 11 through 13. It's a book called Hebrews chapter 11, verse 13. We give honor to the first lady, the co-pastor, by the way.
Praise the
Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. She over there. We give honor to the shepherd mother. Thank God for the shepherd mother. Hebrews chapter number 2, verse number 11 through 13. The word of the Lord emphatically declares, but before I go into the text, I have to give you the diachronic approval of this text. It is all right if you see yourself in the kingdom as a man.
All right.
When I speak, say man, I'm not talking gender. Homo sapien, human being.
Amen.
We've been so long in the church seeking to be this spiritual being. What is right, doing right, acting right, being right. Struggling with right.
Amen.
But it is all right for you to know that you are a man.
Amen.
The text gives clarity
well.
To the fact that you are the son of man.
All right.
Does not give you permission to live ungodly.
Amen.
Because if any man, look at the text, if any man be in Christ,
yes.
Any man, he's a new creature.
Amen.
What the text is bringing clarity to is the fact that God uses man.
All right.
The Bible said, God is a spirit, but they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. So the text today gives Reverend Dr. DJ us a kind of correlation.
Yes, sir.
With God and man, what correlation means is you have he who is the spirit.
Yes.
Aligning himself to that one who is a man.
All right.
To correlate means I take the text and I give it in correlation human perspective.
Amen. All right.
What we made so many, I don't want to call them mistakes, what we need to grow in this area is, it's all right to line your story up with the text.
Amen.
Right.
That's correlation. The sad commentary, MDiv, Master Shekana just got back from Israel. You're a scholar. You are a scholar and you understand that theologians understand that God uses man.
Amen.
Yes.
Bake a cake and don't use a pan.
Well.
Save the world and don't use a man.
All right.
Amen.
Follow?
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Supposed to be holy.
Yes, sir.
Supposed to be saved.
Yes.
supposed to be sanctified.
Yes.
Can't go over there.
Talk, sir.
Don't be seen doing that.
Yes.
You're going to lose your anointing.
Yes.
Don't hang out with those.
Wow.
Don't hang out. How you going to win somebody?
Amen.
If the only thing you do in your life is come to church when you can.
Preaching here, sir.
You got to be spiritual enough.
Yes, sir.
Holy Ghost filled enough.
Yes.
To not to be afraid to live your life.
Amen.
Amen.
I was with some preachers one time, and we were away playing golf. And we thought we were in an exclusive place because we like to play all, you know, the people who shop, they just don't want to go to Crabtree. They want to go to Cary Town Center.
Wow.
Not just Cary Town Center, they want to go to they go to South Point. You shopping, and every now and then, for us good shoppers, we every now and then want to go see what Walmart got.
Wow.
Look at some of y'all. I can tell y'all Walmart. Shop today. Hembridge. Uh-huh. Go over there. I walk through there and see him pick me up, leave a couple of shirts or something. You ain't got to high-end shop all the time. I used to go with my wife to the grocery store when we first got married because they said you're supposed to participate with your wife.
Wow.
You're supposed to show some interest with your new wife and go with her grocery shopping, and she would say, "Baby, I'm getting ready to go to grocery shopping." It's early when we've been married 39 years. I don't know what inside a grocery store look like now, but back then, I was doing what they told me. Go with your wife, push the cart, and pick up the watermelon. You know, I was doing that.
Amen.
We left. I said, "Baby, we don't live this way. Where we going now?" He said, "We're going to the grocery store." I said, "We just left the grocery store." She said, "No, now I got to go get canned goods." I said, "Didn't that store have canned goods?" She said, "They had them, but they wasn't on sale." I said, "Okay, I'm going with my little wife, doing what they say you're supposed to do." Went to the other grocery store, got the canned goods. I'm carrying all that canned goods, putting them in the trunk of the car. Man, I'm doing my thing. We married a long time. Love this girl. Walking behind her while she beating the stuff and pushing the car. Got in the car on our way home in a different direction.
Yes.
I said, "Where are we going now?" She said, "We're going to the grocery store." I said, "Then we just leave the grocery store." She said, "Yeah, but I don't buy my meat there. Now I got to go get the meat."
It's all right, Bishop. It's all right.
I ate all that food. Then grocery store time came up again. I don't know why I caught the flu. She said, "Baby, you don't feel good." She said, "Well, you can't go meet the grocery store." I said, "Baby, go ahead. I'll be here and I'll take the groceries out of the car and blow the horn when you get back." That's when cell phones came out. I said, "Blow the horn, I'll come out and get the I'll get the groceries out of the car when you get back." She said, "Okay." She left. I got picked up when I saw she was gone. I said, "Thank you, Jesus." My point is that you mean something to the kingdom.
Yes. Amen.
But some of y'all see the kingdom as a grocery store. I don't feel like
go.
There's a purpose for you in the earth.
Yes, it is.
Amen.
So when you look at this text, I want to use the word how close the text correlate you with Jesus.
All right.
just to save some kind of space between you and Jesus. But if I were a teacher, right, Sister Scholar, there's no difference in you in the earth than Jesus in the earth.
All right.
Because he became man, he became flesh.
Yes.
And then when he took his exit before Jesus left, he said, greater works than this ye shall.
Yes. Amen.
So let's look at the text.
All right.
Hebrews 2. 11 through 13.
Yes.
For both he that sanctifieth and they who are sanctified are all of one.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir.
Now, if God is Jesus' Father, and we are all of one,
preach,
that makes God Alpha.
Amen. Amen.
Now you might want to use stepson, you might want to say adopted, because sometimes people don't want to see themselves as one.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Because man, Sister Vashonia, needs a greater.
Yes.
Yes.
To validate themselves. To believe in something.
Yes.
Because man has a hard time believing in themselves.
All right.
That's why we say God did it.
All right.
That's right.
The Lord made a way.
That's That's right.
The Lord picked me up and turned me around.
Thank you, God.
I understand that premise. But when you understand the power that you have in Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Preach.
And know who you are in the kingdom as one.
Well,
some stuff, don't get me wrong, you ought to go ahead and take credit.
Amen.
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 Don't say that, say the Lord did. Don't say that, say the Lord did. Don't act like that, you know Jesus did.
That's right.
He gave you strength.
Yes, amen.
He gave you intellect.
Yes.
He gave you authority.
Yes.
He gave you intuition.
Yes. Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
They tell me, Marjolene, they tell me when they put the food in front of me, they said, bless the food. Made me not want to eat because I think the one that cooked it off and blessed it when he took it out of the refrigerator.
All right.
Amen.
So it must get blessed twice.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
You done thawed that meat out all night and you ain't blessed it yet.
Well.
You bless it after it get cooked and put on the table.
Please, sir.
Then some of y'all don't bless the food because you say, all right, bless the table.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to eat the table.
All right.
Some y'all just go with me in the text.
Yes.
There's some things in the earth that requires man.
Amen.
Yes,
sir.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm almost ready to close.
Go ahead on, Bishop.
Thank you, Mama. There's some things in the earth because he who sanctified.
Yes,
sir.
And he who is sanctified are all one.
Yeah.
Let's go. For which cause he is not ashamed to call them brothers.
All right.
Now I'm going to let this 12th verse mess with you. Say, I will declare thy name unto my brother.
Wow.
In the midst of the church will I sing praises unto thee.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. He's talking about the brother.
Yes, he is.
He said, I will sing praises unto thee.
Yes.
He'll sing praises unto you. But we played man down so badly.
Wow.
Until we can't celebrate. Somebody was celebrating me. I know I was celebrating somebody, and I was telling them what a good job. They pointed up and said, to God be the glory. I said, no, I'm talking to you.
Amen. All right.
But if it weren't for the Lord, I'm talking to you. Mm-hmm. Only song y'all let people celebrate y'all with is one song.
What's that?
Happy birthday.
Bishop.
Wow.
Bishop.
You standing there just grinning on one. Is that the only song you know that you can celebrate me with?
My Lord.
Y'all ain't gonna like it. Y'all having a hard time with it? Y'all come on, go with me.
Yes, sir.
I'm gonna holler about three times before I close. The reason why folk catch attitudes with folk because they don't know how to celebrate you.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah. My Lord. Yeah. My Lord.
Yeah. That's good.
That's good.
Can't celebrate you.
Amen.
Have you ever done all you can do the best you can?
Yes.
People come around and don't even say, good job.
Amen.
Have you ever cleaned the house? I mean, clicked it. Got on the floor and with your hand got in the corner. My grandma used to get a razor, the razor, and you take that razor and you get in that corner. Razor all that stuff out that corner. Get it out, clean it, you clean. Huh? You get down there and do the baseball. Get you a pot with some disinfect. Y'all know about clothes, Ajax.
Yeah.
Why y'all ain't talking? Yeah. Get Ajax. Get on your hands and knees. Yeah. Every time we had to clean like that, Cynthia got sick. All of us had a pot on the floor going around the baseball. Getting the real white. Cynthia in the bed talking about she's sick. She don't feel good. How ammonia eat up her hand.
Come on now.
She had all kind of. Yes, yes, you should have said amen. We had to get in there and get it clean.
Yes, yes.
That's the same respect you ought to have in the King.
Amen.
Amen.
Why are you running around here talking about what you don't do?
Well,
you ought to be talking about what is there for my hands to do.
Amen.
Amen.
In your life, in your living, you are valuable.
Amen.
To the kingdom, y'all.
Amen.
I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna watch this. Saying, I will declare thy name. Y'all don't sing no song.
Yeah.
Don't praise no man. Thank you, sir. Saying, I will declare thy name unto my brother.
Yeah.
I was in Danville the other day with a meeting with Apostle Campbell, and he said, told me to tell you hi, Mom. And he said, how's Cheryl doing? I said, she's doing fine. He said, make sure you tell Cheryl. I asked about it. I said, yes, sir, Chief. He said, your daughter doing good? Yes, sir. Is she still working? Yes, sir. I said, yes, sir. And he said, don't forget to tell the district counselor. I said, hi. And he laughed. Amen. Y'all choose who y'all celebrate.
All right.
Yes.
Yes. And y'all feel good talking about who you don't like.
Yeah. Well,
that's right.
You feel just the same. Stay with me.
Talk to
me. Sanctified. Talk to me, young back there. Yeah. Filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Going to heaven.
Uh-huh.
And ain't said nothing to three people on your road.
Uh-huh.
Not only should you speak to me,
well,
you ought to sing the song to me you wrote about.
All right.
Come on now.
Well, I heard you.
Even the man cutting out on his wife wrote a song to his sweetheart. Secret lovers, that's what we are. trying to. That's all right. See that? Hold on. That's all right. Trying to act like y'all real safe. But my song. You write a song to your cutout.
Come on, Bishop.
Huh? Amen. Write a song to him.
Yes, he did.
Don't you? But why are you going to talk? Write a song to the one you love.
Well,
huh? Glory, preacher.
I hate to meet you here today. There's so many things to say. Please don't stop me till I'm through. This is something I hate to do. We've been meeting here so long. What we've done, oh, so wrong. Please don't stop me from through.
All right.
This is something I hate to do. I didn't know it was a cutout song. I just liked the Manhattan. Here's my handkerchief. Wipe your eyes. Let's just kiss and say goodbye. But when you first met him, or when you first met him and first met her, you said, turn out the lights. The world know how to celebrate the getting together.
Amen.
And the breakup.
Yes, that's good. Yes.
But we in the church will not celebrate everybody. I don't want to get involved. Let me tell you what the Bible said. He said, say it, I will declare thy name.
Yes.
I'll say your name. I'll say your name. Y'all stay with me. I'll say your name. Mm-hmm. I got 15 minutes, Shamar. I'll say your name.
Yes.
Y'all around here talking about, I wish I would let your name come out of my mouth. What's wrong with you? Huh? You got openings on the job, and you got people in the church who don't need the job, but you don't like them. You won't even say their name.
All right.
And you good with the boss thing. You good with the HR person. Listen, I got somebody on my
That's right.
Amen. Won't even say their name. I'm not ashamed to declare your name.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'll say your name. You ought to be willing to say my name.
Amen.
But guess what we say? But guess when we say your name? When it's up in some gossip.
Amen.
Y'all come over here.
Right.
And I'm ready to drag your name through the mud. Don't tell them I said it. Because the one that listens to the gospel going to ask one question in the whole gospel. Who is it? No, I don't want to say the name to them. I ain't going to tell them.
Amen.
If you can say my name in gossip, why you can't say my name in celebration?
That's good.
You know, tell somebody, don't get bold at it. I mean, grab two or three people behind you too. Tell them, celebrate my name.
Celebrate my name.
I know what y'all said. Put some respect on it. Y'all keep it up that man with you. He was telling the truth. Put some respect on my name. Don't just put blood on my name. Put some respect. When you y'all ain't my name. I'm going to talk about some Jesus stuff in here. But see, they'll holler if I tell you cut loose your haters. That's all the church do. We always celebrate when we talk about cut loose. Don't have nothing to do with it. Go by yourself. You can go by yourself, Father Jesus, by yourself. No, they ain't existing. They need to say, come here. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. Some of y'all ain't gonna do it. But I know some of y'all ain't gonna do it. But I dare everybody to wave your hand and say, I just love everybody. Come on, let's go. I'm out from the bar and teach you all y'all. Declare your name.
Yes,
sir.
Yes.
Now, DJ, I want you to hear something.
Yes, sir.
If Jesus declared your name, he has spoken your name to his Father.
Amen.
My Father, which is in heaven.
Yes.
Hallowed be thy name.
Yes.
Thy kingdom come.
Yes.
Thy will be done in earth.
Oh,
Then they kept the road.
Yes.
Then the ignorant, you talking to them, what's that? Oh, that side, this side, what's that?
Tell them the truth.
So the call, how are you gonna come to church?
Go ahead, preacher.
Don't speak to me.
Right. Huh? Right.
And the Bible said, you gonna call my name in the church.
All right. Great, sir.
You want to jump?
Yes.
You want to shout?
Well.
You want to speak in tongues?
Well.
How about saying something good about me first?
Amen. Yeah. Hey,
the people on your section first.
All right.
Tap them on the shoulder. It's so good to see you this morning. Y'all ain't doing it. Y'all ain't gonna bear with you. Come on, reach to the one that ain't reaching at you. Hey. Reach to the one. Hey, good to see you. You ought to get some joy.
Amen.
You ought to get some joy when you don't come in here snooty fat.
That's right.
Fly out on my heart.
Yes.
And that's first with some heart in it.
Yes.
You don't come to church with your nose in there.
Yes.
You don't come to God's house talking about what you don't do.
Yes.
You must think you give yourself strength.
Amen.
Come on.
Seems like when you're doing God's business, the more strength you get.
Yeah.
Seems like when you're working for Jesus, I'm up here trying to sit down, but the longer I preach, the stronger I get.
Amen.
More I feel like preaching. More I feel like talking about Jesus. More I'm happy to see you. How do you get it? They said in the early church, he didn't have to do it. But he did call me out of darkness. In the midst of the church, will I sing praises? Sing praise unto thee. That sounds like to God. He's talking about the brother.
All right.
Huh? We were singing happy birthday to everybody on their birthday, right? Individually. One of my members came and said, Bishop, that takes too much time. Why don't you just... all the January people just sing one time. All the February people sing. I said, now wait, stop. Because we're going to have a problem when you get to March.
All right.
Because that's my birthday.
Amen.
I want individual.
Amen.
For one thing, I want individuals.
Amen.
You can tell who studied something about you.
Amen.
Because they'll walk up to you. They say, happy birthday to you.
Yeah.
Always happy birthday. Wait a minute, hold it. Sing a song to me in the church.
All right, then. Best
I'm stuck right there, baby. I'm sorry. I'm trying to move on. Sing a song to me in the church.
Wow.
Amen.
Huh? There's a gentleman whose birthday is March 3rd with mine. And he calls me every March 3rd. And he don't sing the regular happy birthday. He a man. but he's a man. But he always, I pick up, and he said, I just called.
Yes.
To say, let me say, happy birthday.
Yeah.
I just called to say, enjoy your day.
Yes.
I just called to say, happy birthday. And I mean it from the bottom of my heart. It's a man.
Yes.
I would take that from a man. Because ain't right. Now mama called a song to me.
All right. I heard you.
Huh?
I heard you.
Saying no regular happy birthday song to me. They changed it up for Mama King. Happy birthday to me. No, I ain't regular. Put some juice in it.
All right.
Sing a song to them to stay right here.
Yes, wow.
If folk can't celebrate you, y'all want to dance, y'all want to jump and shout. If folk can't celebrate you, be careful.
Yeah.
If they can't make you the attraction, be careful.
Breathe.
You ain't got to cut them loose. Just know they don't see you on the level where you are.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Right. Hallelujah.
Now let's close. I'm closing. Shamar, get ready to dance, son. He said, I'll say praise to you in church. Watch this. And again, I will put my trust in him.
All right.
Wait a minute. You know this cannot be talking about Jesus, because if it was talking about Jesus, it could not say and again.
All right. Good, sir.
And again, I will put my trust in him. In other words, you missed some days celebrating me. Y'all don't like this. You missed some days acknowledging me. I was in your presence, and you didn't even come over to speak to me.
All right.
Right? Now, I was taught coming up, it could be wrong, but I was taught coming up, the person in the room is obligated to speak to the room.
Huh?
Yes.
Hey,
you talk to me.
Yes, sir.
You supposed to speak to me.
That's right. Right.
And again, since your reason to return.
All right.
And again, since you and your friends have had a meeting talking about who y'all ain't talking to. But guess what? Your friend ain't got no heaven, no hell to put you in.
Amen.
I'm going to holler in a minute.
That's right.
Say that again, I will put, give me some bottle. My trust in him, watch this, and again.
Oh, yes.
Behold,
well.
I am the children.
Yes.
I am the children which God hath given me.
All right.
Jesus inhabits you.
That's right. That's right, sir.
Come on now. Teach it.
If you want your children blessed, you better teach that thing how to say good morning.
Yeah.
If you want your child to be successful in life, you better teach that child how to say thank you. You better teach what they call, teach them some now. I was in church the other night, and I was sitting behind a little boy, and I'm standing in back. The boy was sitting right here. He had to be about 12, 13, but he had his phone on. Church going on, and I could barely see because the screen looked like a spiderweb. That little boy in the church was looking at stuff I'm not going to tell you. But something got in his right hand.
Come on now.
Mama in the front.
Come on now.
Dance.
Come on, preacher.
Mama.
Come on, preacher.
That little boy in the back of the church. Mama.
Come on now.
Now, when we were coming along and I ain't messing with nobody about the past.
Come on, preacher.
We had that. Excuse me. Put the chair right here. Hurry up. Put the chair. Be up. I was 5 years old. Right here. Put it back to you. Come here, sin. Y'all act like you're grown. Right here. Come in, DJ, and be tight. Put it on chair. I'm a preacher. I preach like I want.
Amen.
Right there. Give me one more chair. Come here, baby. I know you've been visiting, but you've been coming. You almost remember. Sit right there. Every Saturday, Sunday morning, you're going to play your sister. You tell that person that I'm not going to. Every Sunday morning, where your children sitting at right now?
All right.
Right there. Every Sunday morning.
That's right.
The next Sunday morning, I was in the worst seat because this Sunday I had to sit beside mama. So we fuss. Who gonna sit beside mama? Because you mean. So the next Sunday we moved. I ain't sit beside mama. Next Sunday we moved. Shoot. I can sit beside mom. She had to look down at me. But she didn't have to do that to DJ. She did it because he sit beside her. She just in the mouth. But look where we are now. Because they taught us something.
Yes.
And my dad would be in the pulpit. Now, I'm going to show y'all him. I'm going to show y'all him.
Yes, Lord.
Sure, there's some preaching here somewhere.
Yes, Lord.
I'm going to show y'all because you got to understand God in his name.
Yes.
This is my daddy in the pulpit. We already sitting in prison. We already bound and shot. Not like you going to sleep. Now look back up.
Yes,
preach. Go on, preach. DJ, look like you ain't paying no attention. Look at the wall. Now look back. I just start crying. Then I'm going to send your sister in the pink to go get your switches. Yeah. Y'all see that? The point I'm trying to make is that is a protocol.
Come on.
Yeah. In the house of God, if some, I can't teach you now because I'm broke, but if your mom and dad taught you, I'm telling you, you need to be taught. Because the, I'm going to tell them, Terrence, the Bible said, again, I will put my trust in him, and again, behold, I am the children which God hath given thee.
Yeah.
The same blessing God gave your mama and your daddy, he's going to give it to the children. I'm making you be respectful, so when you get grown, you'll get a miracle in your life. For me and my children.
Yes, sir.
God's going to bless again.
Amen.
Me and my children.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Pay attention.
Thank you, Jesus.
Me and my children.
Yes, Lord.
Learn to pray.
Yes, sir.
Me and my children.
Yes. Amen.
Trust in God.
Yes.
Me and my children.
Hallelujah.
Obey your elders.
Yes, Lord.
Me and my children.
Yes.
Respect your elders.
Yes.
Me and my children.
Yes.
I was checking in the hotel in Jacksonville And I was already at the door, and this old woman pulled up. She pulled up, and she was still in the car. And I'm at the door. I could have walked on in, but Mama had to get her stuff out of the car. I didn't know the lady, but she was Mama. Right. I stood there until Mama got her stuff and brought it. I held the door for her. She said, "Thank you, baby. Somebody taught you some manners." Yeah. Yeah. I'm back to what I said last Sunday. Mm-hmm. Who taught you?
All right.
Who taught you?
Well.
Who's responsible for taking time with you? Because don't you know, on this youth day, I'm preaching the youth day service. Don't you know, young people, the way you carry yourself and the way you respond to people got a whole lot to do. Some of y'all, if we just act right, you don't even have to go over the interview. She worked for the state of North Carolina.
Yes.
I still remember the man who hired you. What's the life?
Yeah.
Walked in the office looking like something.
Yes. Yes.
She didn't even get to sit down in front of the man. He looked at her and said, "Oh, we need you around here. You look nice. You dress nice. Start hunting."
Uh-huh.
Right there.
Uh-huh.
Don't you?
Come on here and say
yes.
It.
Don't you know? Having some manners?
Yeah.
Will get you some help?
Yes.
Don't you know being respectful?
Yes.
The Bible said, "I'm going to do it again."
Yes.
For you and your children.
Yes.
But that child cut the fool because
talk.
That child don't know how to act because y'all don't say good morning when y'all wake up in your own house.
Yes.
You're not saying thank you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Somebody do something for your clothes. This is a young people message.
Yeah.
You're supposed to say thank you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen.
Theo was doing, we were playing golf and doing something. And DJ Theo was getting up, whatever, I forget what we were doing. And every time he would hand me something, I said thank you. And going on something else happened. I think we were playing golf. Because he would go get him a ball, I hit it in the bush, and Theo would get it. He'd bring it back to him, I said thank you. Kept on playing. He did something else for me. He said, "Bishop, you left your club on the ground." He went and got my club, brought it to me. I said, "Thank you." Theo asked a question. He said, "Do you have to say thank you for everything?"
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't say one thank you and they take care of the whole day.
Amen.
You don't say thank you for the whole day.
Amen.
I said thank you when I got up this morning. That's enough. You got to be polite.
Yes.
God bless you. Those on Facebook and YouTube, thank you. Go to Raise More, but that's our giving now. And if you want to share an offering, you can share with us in Jesus' name. God bless you.